All right, so by this point, we've put a ton of work into this. We've spent a lot of time connecting to our data sources, tying them together with a proper normalized data model, and then building out a ton of powerful calculated fields and measures to add new metrics like rolling profit, return rates, order targets, a lot of really great stuff that we've done. But the thing is, it all means nothing until we can actually communicate it and visualize it and allow users to interact with it. So that brings us to the final phase of the business intelligence workflow, which is actually visualizing the data with reports and dashboards. So let's kick off this section with a quick walkthrough of the Power BI report view. Now, we spent some time in here already working with those matrix visuals, but we were really only using those to check our measure values, nothing else. And I think you've probably realized there's a huge amount of functionality and a huge library of tools that we haven't even touched yet. So that's what I want to spend our time focusing on in this section, is working through each of these panes and toolbars and options to see exactly what we can do in this report view. So let's walk through some of them. First up, at the top in our view tab, you've got some basic view options. We're going to talk about phone versus desktop layout. You can show grid lines. You can allow your objects and charts to snap to a grid for alignment. And you can also activate other panes like the bookmarks and selection pane. Down at the bottom of the screen, you'll see report pages. Now these look just like Excel tabs and they function the same way. Think of each page as its own blank reporting canvas. So a single report can be made up of multiple individual pages. In this example we're looking at here, and the example that we're going to build together, we're going to have an executive summary page, a product detail page, and a customer detail page. On the right side, you've got two primary panes. These are like mission control for reporting, visualizations and fields. So starting with visualizations, this shows you all of the chart templates that you have to work with. Charts, slicers, matrices like we've been working with, different types of maps, etc. And just keep in mind that for the purposes of this course, we're working with the standard kind of default set, none of the preview options, but it's very, very easy by clicking those three dots in the lower right to import either new preview visuals or to import custom visuals. Now on the right, you've got your field list. We've seen this before. It's accessible in the data view as well. This is simply where you can access all of the fields and all of the measures and columns across all of your tables. Now, right beneath the visualizations box, you'll see a pane that includes fields, format, and analytics. So there are actually three panes embedded within this. Now, by default, you're going to start in the fields pane, which is what we're seeing here, because that's where you drag in your metrics. It's how you actually tell Power BI what you want that visual to be showing. So in the matrix view, we had rows and columns and values. In this example, we've got a KPI visual that needs an indicator, a trend axis, and a target goal. So what you'll notice is that these panes are completely dynamic. You'll see different options depending on what type of visualization you're using and what fields and objects you have selected. So the fields view within this pane is where you drag those columns or dimensions and values. The next tab, the little paintbrush, contains all of your formatting options, which we'll dig into. And the third, the little magnifying glass, that's called the analytics view. And that includes options to do some interesting things like trend lines and forecasts. Now, the last thing to note here is the filters pane, which includes four different types of filters: visual level, page level, report level, and drill through. We're going to talk about those and practice them in a later lecture. But for now, just remember that those impact the specific scope of data that gets filtered. So let's quickly jump into our report view and take a look for ourselves. All right, here we are in our AdventureWorks report, right where we left it at the end of the DAX section. What we can actually do here is go ahead and delete this matrix visual. So now I've got a fully clean canvas, clean slate to work with. And now you'll notice those view tabs we talked about. You can show the grid lines. You can enable the snap to grid if you want to make sure you're working with clean alignment. You can activate your bookmarks pane or your selection pane, which just pops up next to visuals. And then let's uncheck grid lines down at the bottom. See, we've defaulted to page one. You can easily add a new page or delete it, just like Excel tabs. And then here's our command center, visualizations and fields. So these can be collapsed if you want to save space, but these will always live here on the right side of your view. And as always, we've got access to all of our fields here. And then as soon as we drag in a visual, we'll have access to the fields options as well as the formatting options in this pane. So with that, let's go ahead and get started by adding our first objects to our report.